right, guys, we've been training together for a few days now, and we are a little sore. We're spent. So we're going to do something we've never done before together, because we're always coming up with new things. This was Jen's idea. We're going to get into an ice bath. Now, we're not just doing it for the video. There's reasons why we take ice baths, and I use it fairly often. You don't use it? Okay. So it's for inflammation. So especially when I'm training strongman and CrossFit, I feel like I need it. You are taxing all of the muscle groups all the time, constantly. So an ice bath is going to help you with inflammation. In strongman, I use it and I go ice to hot, which we don't have access to hot right now. But I rotate 20 minutes on, 20 minutes off, going ice, going into the hot bath.
What do you mean, a hot bath
or
like a sauna?
So I'll do a complete ice bath. You could use a sauna too, but I just go at home.
Okay.
Ice bath, hot bath, ice bath, hot bath. And it helps to calm down your central nervous system.
Okay.
So when you overload your central nervous system, you need to bring it back down. So this is a way to do it. We're going to do it today.
And we're going to add a twist.
With a Q&A. So we both posted on Instagram, ask us some fitness questions. So they're coming at you now. But first, we have to put ice in the ice bath.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
My body size. I don't know what that means, but I'm 5'6 and I'm 157 pounds. My measurements are, I think it was 41, 27. It was 40, but it's definitely 39.
It was
41.25 and then I lost a lot and then I gained it back,
uh-huh.
But I'm still not quite 40.
Okay.
My booty's strong.
So.
Okay, you go.
Do you ever think of competing on stage?
Woo!
I actually did.
Oh yeah, I do.
I actually did a long time ago, and PJ actually gave me a lot of critiques that I don't think I was ready for. So I know that the way my body's built, I would have to do a lot of work to get on stage, even though I'm fit.
And
no more of the competitions and lifting as heavy as I do. So the answer, more than likely, is no. We also just filmed a video.
Posing
and doing vacuums, which I am clearly inept at doing vacuums.
How is this not affecting you?
I do this. You don't do this often. You're shaking.
Yeah.
I do this. So that's another thing too. But we just did a video. Jen taught me how to pose, how to strut. It's entertaining, so definitely go check it out.
Okay. What does a lovely lady like you want in a man? I am single, by the way. What do I want in a man? Everybody thinks that I want somebody that's shredded, but I don't. I do want somebody that respects the gym and works out hard. They don't have to even be as strong as me. That's kind of douchey for me to say. I want somebody that I have good chemistry with, somebody that makes me laugh, and somebody that has a strong work ethic that wants to be better, because I'm like a workhorse, so I can't have anybody lazy. All right,
I get that. Okay. Favorite ab routine. So anything I do with abs now, me and Jen just filmed a workout where she instructed me. I also did a workout with Marissa a couple months ago where I instructed her. I like to do circuits for core. Personally, that's my favorite way to do it. I like them to burn for a good like 8 minutes straight through. So I usually pick 4 or 5 exercises, hit 15 to 20 reps on each with little to no rest in between sets and little to no rest in between movements. That's how I train my abs.
Okay. Biggest pet peeve, late and spitefulness.
Oh, that's fair. How many days do you work out? I work out 6 days. Sunday,
training?
Training, yeah. Okay. Sunday is my mandatory recovery day.
Okay, leg press PR. Leg press PR is when, not 8 years ago, before I started competing, before I started bulking, sitting at 132 pounds, 12 plates on each side.
I can't even picture you 132 pounds.
I know. That's 12 plates on each side for like 12 to 15 reps.
Wow.
Range of motion, 90 degree angle.
Do you bench press? If so, how often? Yes, I have not been bench pressing recently, but I do love to bench press. I think I'm fairly good at it for my size. I would do it like twice a week, and I change from narrow grip to regular wide grip, but now currently I prefer dumbbells just because of my shoulder and range of motion.
What is my meal plan? So we actually just did a video of my pre-competition meal plan, and we'll probably do like an updated one, so go check out that video because I'm not going to spend time on here when you can go watch the video.
Your training breakdown, how many weeks per phase do you do? So when I'm training CrossFit or strongman, usually it's 12 weeks, and I usually go 12 weeks out for a competition before a strongman show. However, right now, with my shoulder injury, I have not been doing that, and I get bored very easily when I'm not training CrossFit and strongman, so I've been doing 8 to 10 weeks and then changing it up again because it keeps me from getting bored, and I know my body.
Okay. How many days do I train and how long? So my split is Monday, I do back and a little bit of rear delts. Tuesday, quads only. Wednesday, shoulders, buys, and tries. Really just shoulders. Thursday, back again. Friday, glutes only. Saturday, off. And Sunday, hamstrings only. Oh, and how long? My leg days are about an hour and 15 minutes, and my upper body days are about an hour. The shoulder workout, maybe 45 minutes, 35 minutes.
Yeah, sure. Smaller muscle groups. Thoughts on intermittent fasting? Actually, the first thing Jen said to me when I got here was, are you still fasting? So I actually did intermittent fasting for a solid year. I really did like it. However, it actually worked really well when I was doing just CrossFit. But now that I'm training, I'm trying to grow my booty and grow my quads. So I don't think it's conducive to that style of training. You need to eat to build muscle. And I wasn't eating enough. So I changed it. So now I'm eating 5 times a day. As far as intermittent fasting goes, I think it does work. It just depends on the style of training that you're doing. So you do have to be able to listen and feel your body. Yeah, and based on like the goals that you have. I want to put on size. I don't think it's conducive to putting on size.
Building quads after patella tendonitis. So first off, I would say if you have tendonitis in your patella, you should probably get some work done. And I am a huge fan of dry needling. And it can absolutely work through that or help. Like I had tendonitis in my elbow, and I worked with a dry needling guy twice, and it's gone. So I think that basically you can build your quads just as long as you work on the tendonitis first, recover, and then just start training to build your quads the way that, you know, hypertrophy training, and that's really it. But you got to fix the problem first.
That being said, yeah, so kind of stemming from what she's saying, if you have an injury, don't ignore it. It's not going to just go away on its own. You have to have body work done. You have to take care of it. You have to take your ice baths. Another thing, actually, I just recommended to Justin O'Donnell. He had back pain yesterday, and I was like, take an apple cider vinegar bath. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
Yeah, so my masseuse said to take an apple cider vinegar bath when I had a, I thought I may have torn my quad. It was not a tear. It was pretty big contusion, but I did an apple cider vinegar bath, hot bath.
So how much Epsom salt,
you use 1 quart of apple cider vinegar for recovery and a normal serving of your Epsom salt, no bath soaps.
Okay.
Just the salt and the vinegar. It smells nasty. You're going to smell like an Easter egg when you're done. So take a shower. But for recovery, it reduces inflammation and it helps you to recover. So that is something that I highly recommend. Okay, my turn, right?
Yep.
Would you consider cross-training into MMA? I don't know if I'm getting that question because I did that one video learning how to MMA fight. But
That was last summer.
But no, I have all these muscles and I don't know how to use them. So the answer to
Everybody's like, I don't want to mess with you. And you're like, go ahead and mess with me.
I don't know how to throw a punch. No, so the answer is no. It actually makes me nervous, like fighting. So I don't think that I would be tough enough to do that.
Can I tell them? So the last time when they came to Vegas, I was we were trying to come up with ideas, and I said, "Why don't we do some jiu-jitsu?"
Oh yeah, she said absolutely not. Absolutely not. I'll punch a punching bag, but that's all I got. And even that's.
Okay, so somebody asked me, "What's my hardest body part to train?" It depends on what you mean by hard. Like I really push my quads. Mentally, the hardest is biceps and triceps because I hate doing them. Lats a little back a little bit only because of my ladies, my implants. Just to kind of piggyback off of you, your ladies are over the muscle,
correct?
So it's okay for her to do chest. Mine are under the muscle, so I shouldn't do chest. But sometimes some back exercises will have it fire a little bit, like some tricep exercises. So that, I mean, in reference to that hard, that's how I would kind of answer that question.
Okay.
I guess.
How to get monster quads like you? I like to train on a barbell. To me, training heavy machines is great, but I've always trained on a barbell. I've been squatting since I was in high school. We had a powerlifting gym style when I was playing soccer. Did it in college. I mean, I've been squatting for years. So, I mean, there's nothing can replace a barbell squat.
Okay. What cutting things? Okay. So, if you're, first of all, I always say this to people, hire a professional. If you have it in your budget, hire somebody to work through helping you cut, helping you lose, whatever it is that you want to do. If you don't have it in your budget, I would recommend just tracking what you're doing now if you're not, and then start cutting from there if you can't budget. Like, whatever it is that you're doing, if you have no idea, just start putting it in. Try to come up with some kind of game plan, put it in a tracker, and then follow that consistently, and then slowly start cutting from there. But at the end of the day, if your car broke down and you're not a mechanic, I wouldn't say go to YouTube and look up how to fix your car. You're going to have somebody do it. So hire a professional that's going to, because there's a science to it. There's refeeds. There's a purpose to everything that you do. There's the reason why you have a certain amount of protein, carbs, fat in your plan. So carb cycling, keto, there's a million different things. And some things will work and some things won't. So simple would be, I would say, hire a professional. And then second, if you do not have your budget, start with tracking and cutting from there.
Can you drink beer and still be fit? I'm going to be honest. I don't believe so. Beer has a lot of...
hops.
Yes. A lot of carbs. A lot of hops.
But there are beers that have no carbs and no calories, but it's the hops in beer that slow down your fat-burning systems and increase belly fat.
Right. So, and guys, I'm going to be, like, completely honest here. Me and Chris do drink. We enjoy a good drink. But we're very... specific on the types of alcohol that we drink, and you will not, I mean, for me for sure, you will not see me drinking a beer, you won't see me drinking a seltzer, anything carbonated, even soda, like, I'm not drinking it. It doesn't agree with my system, and I feel bloated immediately after. I'm more of a vodka water or like a straight tequila kind of girl. You'll see me drink like a martini straight up, but I'm not drinking beer. And even though you see us posting online a lot of alcohol, We are selective with the days that we do choose to drink. So you can drink every day.
And keep in mind the intensity of her training and the amount of muscle that she holds on to and how fast her metabolism is. Unfortunately, most people don't have that. So she could maybe get away with having a refeed or a wine more often than the average person. So you have to take that into consideration. How intense are you training? How much muscle do you have? Like, are you sitting at a very high body fat? Then you have no business having a drink every single week. Like, maybe once every 3 weeks, or once you get to goal, maybe once a week, again, with a better choice of alcohol.
Also, if you have the ability to get into, like, an in-body scan or something that's going to track your visceral fat, if you're drinking a lot of alcohol, your visceral fat is going to be higher than somebody that's not drinking a lot of alcohol. And that's the fat that goes around, that's stored around your organs. That's the fat that breeds cancer. So that's the kind of fat you want to get rid of. So if you're somebody that's holding a lot more body fat, definitely stay away from the alcohol, because that's just working full on against you.
Okay, so I don't know if this has to do with that this is someone's fetish?
Okay.
Or if they know that I used to do jiu-jitsu. So I'm a blue belt in jiu-jitsu. I got my blue belt from Cesar Gracie 8 years ago. This person asked me if I've ever head scissored anyone until they tapped, which is technically a triangle choke, which yes, I have. So that's the answer to that.
That's a fetish.
I'm pretty sure that this was a fetish question and not, I know you do jiu-jitsu or did jiu-jitsu.
Following that, will you be able to beat Jen in a wrestling match?
Probably?
No.
Okay.
I could probably clean and press her over my head.
Yes.
If she stood very still, but
I'll be like, yes.
That's about it.
My favorite color is red and purple. Deep purple,
yeah.
And deep,
like royal, maroon, like purple, red. Like royalty. That sounds really douchey, but that was my actually our wedding color.
Purple like royalty?
It does, but like it's like that. It's like a deep purple.
Okay, yeah, that's what.
Not like lavender. I don't like lavender.
What's your secret to beauty? I don't know what this means, but let's just say I really don't.
I take care of myself.
I drink a lot of water. Somebody did ask me how much water I drink. I drink about a gallon and a half right now. What about you?
In Myrtle Beach, I'm drinking like 180 ounces.
That's almost a gallon and a half.
Yeah.
So 128.
Yeah, and I track
gallons.
It. If you're tracking it, you're start tracking it, because you'll be surprised at how much
little.
Or how little, probably how little you do drink. When you're tracking it, you're cognizant of it, you're going to drink more.
And when you drink caffeine, you have to
drink more. Yeah.
That doesn't count, and you have to drink more water. How old am I? I just turned 45. My Instagram handle is my date of birth, 7877.
Yeah, so you can't forget her birthday.
Yeah, nobody can. All right. What else? I'm good.
Yeah, I'm good. I think that's it.
A couple inappropriate questions, which
I ignored them.
All right. Ah, I think my toes are numb. They're a little bit blue.
No, but my quads feel a lot better. Your quads feel better?
Yeah, they do. I feel like
yeah.
I can. They're not as like super solid. Oh, look, I can pinch them more.
Yeah, they're.
All right. Should we stand up or stay here?
Stay there.
Okay.
All right, guys. Well, we hope you like this video. We hope we answered all your questions, and I think we're kind of in depth with them. We helped each other out a little bit. So I hope you guys like this.
Learn something and enjoy the view.
Comment below and let us know if you want to see us do this again. We get together, every couple months for sure.
Yeah.
So it's something that we could definitely do again. Get a nice bath and answer your questions.
Or hot tub, because if you guys come out to me, I'll have my pool at my
hot tub.
We
can do the hot tub back and forth thing.
Yes.
You can see how that feels.
So we can get a pool, and then I have the hot tub, and we'll go back and forth. Keep an eye out for that video. All right, guys.
Make sure you like the video, hit the subscribe button, hit the buttons. And we'll see you guys next time.